next person who hugs and kisses me and then says, I'm sick. Please see why I feel justified giving you one swift kick. If you're sick, you must not touch. I can't stress this point too much. I know you love everybody and everybody loves you. Doesn't mean we love your germs and your microbes too. What to do, what to do, what to do. Bring back the bow, starting right now. If you're sick and you touch me, kapow! Come on, sick people, bow. Bring back the bow, I'll show you how. You're thinking that looks easy, wow. Let's bring back the, but maybe bowing is not your style. There's other moves I behoove you to use if you're sick that won't get me riled. For instance, just adopt a serious look. Think Nixon when he said, I am not a crook. Then place your two palms together. Greet people like this next time you're under the weather. Namaste. That's all you say. And it's good if you can pretend to pray when you say namaste. Namaste, we'll keep the sick at bay. Chase colds away with a bold nama, maybe namaste. And bowing for you are too formal. Here's something else you can try, just a bit more normal. If a sneezy person comes toward you with their lips all in a pucker, scream, get away from me, you sick lozenge sucker. Or say namaste and bow. By now you know how. If you're sick and you touch me, kapow! Come on, sick people, bow. Bring back the bow. How now, brown cow? Let's all kowtow. Let's bring back if your head hurts, your belly aches. No hugs, no kisses, no handshakes. Starting here and now. Let's bring back. Don't make me want to smack you. Let's bring back the bow. The knuckle tap is okay too.